It's said that the supreme art of war is to subdue the enemy without fighting. Well, these furry and slimy folks have clearly never heard of that quote. Just like humans, it's often the small guy who starts the fight. Goat versus horse is a bit like a featherweight boxer versus a heavyweight, except featherweight boxers usually don't have horns.
George!
And speaking of heavyweights, even Tyson Fury wouldn't want to face one of these things. Here it is, the giraffe equivalent of a punch below the belt. As we all know, pink is the angriest of all colors. You certainly wouldn't want to be the referee for this fight. If trees had legs, they'd have been running away as soon as this fight got started. It's like Batman and the Joker. Only one can survive. Do you have trouble telling the difference between crocodiles and alligators? Well, here they are side by side, trying to kill each other. Baby Rottweilers, almost as scary as their parents. Apparently, an angry fox is no match for a very relaxed cat behind a tree. When two animals you shouldn't mess with start messing with each other, it's probably best to switch off your camera and run.
Oh my God, baby.
Okay, let's make this a fair fight. Me against both of you. Mongoose versus Cobra is a battle as old as time, although it doesn't always last too long. Has anyone ever thought of separating the giraffes and the ostriches? It's Mongoose and Cobra again, but this fight seems to go on forever. Not sure what's in that oil drum, but it must be worth fighting over. This snake should probably go for more realistic opponents. How about a mongoose? Dogs are naturals at herding cattle. But some cattle are clearly not aware of that fact. Here's another case of lion versus tiger. And if you're traveling down this road, it's also a pretty good reason for arriving late for work. The cat who'd finally had enough. Leave it, man! They ain't worth it! When your best move needs to be done in reverse, it's pretty hard to fight. Get back in the sky, you say? No thanks, I'm perfectly happy right here, in your territory. That horn can do some nasty damage, but then so can those teeth. This is cat language for get away from my kids. What this fight needs is more cowbell. Sheep aren't fighters, they're lovers. No, wait, they're not either of those things. Here's a goat versus a horse again, but this time the goat comes off worse. Sometimes mixed martial arts just isn't interesting enough, and you have to start mixing species too. Sheep and cows are both placid animals, except when they're not. When a boar fights someone who's full of bull, you know when you wrap a chicken or turkey with bacon? Well, this is a bit like that. This is what happens when you look at another man's girlfriend. Dead zebra. A leopard doesn't have to be on top to be enjoying itself. Another mongoose and cobra fight. Actually, wait a minute, are they dancing?
And then, the kill shot. One swift snap to the back of the head, and the spine is severed.
If your main method of attack is to wrap yourself around things, then this is not a good choice of opponent. Tigers are pretty endangered, and after this, there's probably going to be one less in the world. Okay, you look a bit like us, but you're not us. Attack! It's good to see that even majestic, rare animals can still act like idiots. The latest Angry Birds game, now with equally angry rats. And now the latest episode of Bullying in the Jungle. When you accuse your friend of having a big mouth, things can escalate quickly. You don't usually see this kind of thing while you're eating breakfast. Well, not unless the buffet has run out of bacon. A trailer for the new movie, Jaws Times 2. Lions just don't get along with hyenas. In fact, you know it's bad when they even end up fighting in Disney movies. And just to prove my MMA theory from earlier, here are some kangaroos performing taekwondo. Just to prove that there's very little difference between humans and animals, Here's two men fighting over a woman. Two honey badgers and eight lions. Those lions better get some backup. Who would win, mink or rabbit? And which one would make a better coat for Cruella de Vil? And here's the precise reason why that possum didn't want to be caught by those baboons. Weasel and a seagull, fighting in a place that doesn't give either of them any advantage. Once more, this rubbing heads thing just isn't an effective method of attack. Alpacas have big necks, and they know how to use them. Two goats fight it out to determine who the real goat is. This is a battle for animals who really can't be bothered to have a battle. That's right, a woman genuinely just said, "We should stop them before they get hurt."
We should stop them before they get hurt.
Again, is this a fight or just a very enthusiastic mating ritual? How did these two even meet? Yeah, this is not what I was expecting to find up here. Well, here's an animal fight you wouldn't usually see on National Geographic. It's always important to make sure that your dog isn't bored, especially if it's by a wild boar. Can this weakened owl survive being mugged by this gang of crows? You might be surprised. Here's a cat who fluffed around and found out. Have you ever seen a praying mantis hunt? Well, they've got a pretty big appetite. Wait, if you love our videos, be sure to check out Retrocast. And if Retrocast isn't your thing, don't worry. We have another Akimbo video for you.